Hi, hello learners. In this video, we are going to continue that first lesson, the rise of nationalism in Europe, subtopic, the French Revolution and the idea of nation. In European continent, the first concept of, the first clear expression of nationalism emerged after the French Revolution, which happened in 1789. Even you can remember this year very, very easily. Put one after that, 789. You can remember this year very, very easy way. Based on this revolution, the power transferred from monarchical form to the common citizen. How they are just turned as a united nation, as a single country. The French people, they just created the collective identity through various measures. Let's see what are the various measures one by one. First one is the idea of a fatherland and citizens. Based on this one, they are just giving emphasized notion for a united community enjoying equal rights under the constitution. This is the first concept. Second one, new tricolor flag replaced the royal standard flag. Before that, king's flag. Now new tricolor flag replaced that flag. Estate General was renamed as a National Assembly. Fourth one, new hymns were composed, oaths were taken, martyrs commemorate all in the name of nations. Before that, they gave only importance for the king. Now, they are just taking in the name of nations. Fifth one, centralized administrative system, uniform laws for all the peoples within the territory. Internal customs and dues were completely abolished. Equal weights and measures were adopted. And the last one is a regional dialect that's completely disgraced. Instead of that one, they promoted only one language, that is French. So based on this one, they just created the collective sense of identity. They just turned as a single nations. After this French Revolution, these revolutionaries, they had just declared the mission and the destiny of the French nation was to liberate the Europe from the despotism. In other words, we can say that one, they just tried to help the peoples of Europe to turn as a nation states. How this idea of nationalism went abroad? So actually this was idea of nationalism went abroad through the French armies into Holland, Switzerland, Belgium and Italy. The next concept what we are going to learn, that is the Napoleonic Code. Napoleon, he was a ruler of France. He not only destroyed a democracy, he also reintroduced a monarchical form of government in France. He just introduced a code that is known as Napoleonic Code. This code is otherwise known as a Civil Code of 1804. So the three concepts we need to remember in the Napoleonic Code. First one is he did away the privileges based on birth. Second one is equal rights for all the citizens. Third one, secured right to property. These concepts, this code exported to the French control area, whatever the places are occupied by the Napoleon, this code also exported to those places known as German, Dutch Republic and some parts of Switzerland and Italy. Here he just exported this code. Here also he just simplified the administrative division, abolished feudal system, freed peasants from serfdom and manorial dues. In town areas, the guild restrictions completely removed. Transport and communication systems improved a lot. So these things created a big boost for peasants, traders and businessmen. They just found this one as a newfound freedom. So based on this one, they can transfer the goods and capitals from one region to another regions in an easy way. But in some of the French Concord areas, they just showed that mixed reactions. Why there is a mixed reactions with those peoples, especially in Holland and Switzerland and some of the cities like Brussels, Mainz, Milan and Warsaw. Here the population, they just showed that mixed reactions because the political freedom and the administrative reforms not went in a hand in hand. Because in these regions, Napoleon increased the taxation as well as they are just forced recruitment for French armies to conquer the rest of the Europe, as well as complete censorship against the rulers. These things outweigh the advantages of administrative reforms. So in this video, so try to recall the concepts. So French Revolution, how the French peoples created the collective identity, and the third one, how this nationalism concept went abroad. The next one, Napoleonic Code, why this Napoleonic Code, that initial enthusiasm soon turned into hostiles. So these are the informations we just learned in this video. Hope this video is helpful to you all. We will see the remaining subtopics in the upcoming videos. Bye. See you in the next video.